We are going to see how you can easily work with item variants in Business Central. We use the app Master Data Information from Microsoft AppSource. So everything you see in this video is standard functionality out of the box. Let's begin by looking at how variants work on sales orders. We're creating a new sales order for a customer, and we would like to sell some bike shirts. But bike shirts come in many varieties, and we can choose to handle them in two different ways. The first way is to use the item variant matrix order. It is a tool which provides a matrix with all the variants. We choose, for example, one in each size in this color, and then some other sizes and colors. This item has three different dimensions of variants, and we can see them at the top of the matrix. It is size, shirt type, and color. And when we press OK, the seven lines on the sales order are created. It has changed the top line to a comment line, where we can see that the total quantity is 12. This is the first of the methods to create lines on sales orders with items and variants. Now let's say we want to edit the sales order. We just select a random line and enter the matrix again. Then we select 5 of this variant and 2 of another, and when we press OK, it updates the item lines. And now we have 17 items on the sales order in total. We can add one more item, which also has variants. We go into the matrix again and select some variants. And this way, we get 2 items with variants on the sales order. There is an alternative to using the matrix. This item that we started with, it has 3 dimensions. We will just take a look at it in the matrix. It has color, shirt type, and then columns with sizes. We can define by ourselves which variant dimensions an item must use, and an item can actually have up to 15 dimensions. If we want more detail, then we can handle the variants as lines instead of in a matrix. Here we have 1 line per variant. This gives more lines, but in return we get a lot more information. We can also edit this list directly. We can choose 7 of this one instead of 5. The interesting thing about this list is that we only see the combinations that actually exist. And it can also manage prices and discounts. So if there is a discount on the top item number, it adds up the total quantity of variants, which here is 19. Now let's see how to create new items with variants. We look through the items list, and we can recognize that there is an item here that has variants. These are variants of item number 3900. And further down we find item number 4000 and the variants that belong to that item. Here in the items list, we can choose to hide all the variants so that we can more easily see all the main products. We choose Show Hide Variants, so now we only see the main items. We can also choose that we only want to see the items for which there are variants. Then all the regular items are filtered out in this view. Then we can see that in this demo set, we only have 3 items where we work with variants. Let's create a new item. We will create a copy of item number 3900, and then we can look at how it is configured. Let's say the new item is a football shirt, and we want to include the master data when we copy, and also all the values. Now we have a new item, and then we go into the master data specifications. They have been duplicated to this new item, and now we can edit the data to make it fit the new item. When we go to the item card, it is important to give it a style name. It has inherited the name from the old item, and it is important to get it changed because it is the name that is the basis for all the variants that we will create shortly. We must also choose a style template. It is the style template that controls which dimensions the individual item has variants of. This t-shirt template has variants on size, color, and shirt type. And this is regular master data in Business Central. We can choose, for example, the color on the product, and we can see that the options are blue, green, and red. And we can create all the options we want. This way, the style template controls which variants are relevant for an item. If we have food, then we could create a style template for food. And in that, we could create flavor as a dimension. In this way, we can work with sizes and colors on t-shirts and with flavors on food. Notice that the most important master data is located directly on the item card. And we can change the master data directly here. Now we want to create a lot of variants of our football shirt. Therefore, we open Create Item Variant, which is a worksheet for creating variants. We have chosen item 3800, and we use t-shirt as a template, which means that we can create variants on sizes, colors, and shirt types. Now we get the system to suggest new variants. We can choose to start from a certain number, and we can choose the field delimiter for the item number. And then we can choose which variants we would like to have created, for example, certain sizes. And we can choose that we only want red variants. And we could also select shirt types. When we press OK, Business Central suggests 16 new variants to us. Now we can choose to add some more. We choose those which are different from red and which are size large and only regular. This gives us two more lines. This is how we create suggestions for new variants. And now we can select the variants that we would like to have created in Business Central. We don't need to create all variants at once. We can take them one at a time. Notice that we have all the variants master data in columns over here on the right. And as mentioned, there can be up to 15 different dimensions of master data. And this is controlled by the style template that we have chosen for this item. So if we used a flavor template, we would see some completely different columns here. Now we choose that we would like to create all these suggestions for variants. When we press Carry Out, Business Central creates all the new item numbers with variants. That makes 26 in total. And afterwards, we can delete the lines from this worksheet because now we have finished creating variants. When we go back to the item overview and find item number 3800, we now have all the variants. And if we open one of the variants, we can see the master data that applies to exactly this variant. Let's try adding this item to a sales order. We can find the same sales order as we used last time. Down in the sales order lines, we create a new line with item number 3800. And then we enter the variant matrix. And then we can choose which variants we want to add to the sales order. Now we will look at how we maintain items and variants in an easy way. There is a style matrix where we can easily view the variants and do mass updates. Here we have the matrix for item number 3800, and we can see all the variants that have been created. And here we can easily update master data on all dimensions for all variants. We can go back to the item list and select item number 3900, and then we get all the variants for that item. it is the template at the top that controls which columns we have in the matrix. So if we would like to have other editing options, we can choose another template. And of course, we can create exactly the templates we need. For example, we can select item planning data, and then we can edit suppliers, bill of materials, routing, safety stock, and much more. We can, for example, change the safety stock of individual items, but there are also tools to mass update data for many variants in one go. So this is an easy way to maintain data on variants. If you prefer to use Business Central's item variant codes, that is also an option. It is just an alternative for those who prefer item variant codes. There are no variant items on this item in the item list. And this is because there are variant codes for this item. They are located in the menu under Variants. These variant codes are also built with the master data functionality. So if we select a variant and go into master data specifications, we can see the master data that has generated the variant code. It is all controlled by the template that we have chosen for the item. On this item, we use a template called T-shirt variant. And if we look at it, we can see that it uses table 5401, which is Business Central's variant codes. This is the reason why this item has variant codes instead of item variants. Let's go into the worksheet that we use to create new variants. There we use the same template, T-shirt variant, and then we choose to suggest new records. We would like to continue from number 110, and then we have the system suggest new variants. This gives us a long list with the same item number and consecutive variant codes. And then we can select which variants we want to create. Now it says import success, and this means that the new variant codes have been created. We go to the item and look at the variant codes. There, the system has created the three variant codes that we selected a moment ago. You can choose whether you want to work with variants as item records or as item variant codes. Or you can use both. It's a matter of preference. Of course, all of this also works on purchase orders. Let's create a new purchase order for a supplier. And then we go into the product lines. We add an item that has variants, and then we can choose one of the two same overviews that we used a little while ago. We select some items from the list and add the variants to the purchase line. This works in exactly the same way as on the sales order. We get three lines with the variants that we have chosen and a total quantity of 17. This was an overall presentation of how to manage variants in Business Central with the app called Master Data Information. You can find the app yourself in Microsoft AppSource, and you can download it as a trial and test it for a long time in your sandbox. This way you can test everything that we have just seen here. You are also very welcome to contact us at Abakian. We will be happy to help you get started with the app.